13-month-old Kody Smart was laid to rest this afternoon following a funeral service in Thorold. The little boy died hours after suffering head injuries in his grandfather's home. As Lauren Sabin reports, Kody was placed in that home just months before by Family and Children's Services, even though the grandfather had previously been convicted of child abuse.
Kody Smart died at McMaster Children's Hospital just hours after suffering head injuries. Family members were told Kody banged his head on the hardwood floor when the dog hit him jumping off the couch at his grandfather's home in Thorold. As with every baby death, homicide detectives are investigating.
As you're aware, he was taken to the hospital in St. Catharines. He was transferred to McMaster Children's Hospital. So there's a great number of doctors that we have to meet with, including the coroner from the chief coroner's office.
Months ago, Family and Children's Services took Kody from his parents' home and put him in the home of Brian Matthews, his paternal grandfather. 20 years ago, Matthews was convicted of child abuse.
Now, Family and Children's Services will not discuss a specific case, and they definitely won't say why they chose to put Kody into the home of a man with a criminal history and who was previously convicted of assaulting his then 6-month-old son.
And here I am, one of the top advocates in this province, fighting for change for the last year, several years since 2009. And I'm here now having to lay my grandson to rest as a result of this very system that was supposed to be put in place to protect children.
This afternoon, Kody's parents, family members, friends, and major crime and child abuse detectives attended the visitation and funeral. Grandfather Brian Matthews was not there. Kody's step-grandfather Chris York says he's been demanding children's aid societies be subject to better government scrutiny.
And I will fight it from my grave if I have to. I'm going to keep pushing until we have something called Kody's Law, because I never want to see another child die as a result of the incompetence that's taking place in these agencies today.
Lauren Sabrin, CHCH News.